And inside, the men finish their warm-ups. This is being used as a selection for the Japanese team for the World Championships, so it is indeed important. And here's a look at the order of skate in the men's short program. Elvis Stoiko got an early draw. Then Takeshi Honda, who is training right now up at the Mariposa Club in Barrie. Emmanuel Sandu, Min Zhang of China, Jean-Francois Hébert. And then Chen Zhang Li, one of the Chinese men who certainly has the jumps. Now let's join Deb and Barb with the call.
Our next competitor, representing Canada, Elvis Stoiko. Here he is, the man the crowd's been waiting for. Elvis Stoiko, three-time world champion. Looking at the four continents as his preparation for the World Championships and another title.
He looks focused here. This is so important for him to get a good one under his belt before the World Championships. He opens with the triple axel combination, and the second element will be the quad. The jump that he missed at the Canadian Championships right here. Oh, that was beautiful. You can tell he's right on top of himself here. The difficulty about doing the quad in the short program is that it must come out of footwork steps, connecting steps. Here it is right here. And he will be the first to do it. He'll go into the history books if he lands it. Oh, 2 feet. Some amazing elements for Elvis. Three jumps, three spins, two footwork sections, but the quad wasn't one of them. What a step up this was, though, from his Canadian's performance. All the elements, including the footwork, were so much more sharp. Here's a look at the opening combination. This was a beauty, just right over top of that landing leg. He does the double on the end. I'm sure he's looking to do the triple on the end of that for Worlds. Here's the quad.
The quad rotation was good.
It was beautiful. It was gorgeous.
I just need more run on it. Just 2 foot.
Rotation not complete.
Let's have a look here. Doesn't quite get all the rotation he needs.
Thank you.
Looks good in the air here.
Thanks.
the thing about trying the quad is that his base mark will be higher because he has tried a more difficult jump. He's going to take a deduction, yes, but the he starts with more.
The judges consider the addition of a quad a much riskier element, of course.
And it is a risk. It's a huge gamble, and we've seen that all season long. Plushenko has tried it twice, missed it twice, and he's given up on it.
Hey, Dad, I love you. For sure here.
Hi, everybody. Nice work.
The marks for
it. It'll be interesting to see what happens at Worlds and how many of them go for it in the short at Worlds.
5-5, 5-3.
Up to 5.6. Presentation marks higher.
5.7.
These are pretty low.
5.6. 5.7. 5.5
is very low for Elvis.
Thank you.
Still first. Takeshi Honda from Japan is a two-time senior national champion. Been having problems with a sprained left ankle. Missed two elements in his short at the recent Japan Nationals and had to withdraw. So he's hoping with a good skate here that the Japanese Federation will name him to their world team.
And that is the only reason he is here and is skating at this event, because he needs to get qualified for the World Championships. He opens with his triple axel combination. Triple toe! He does it! And that is one step up from what Elvis did, because he did the triple on the end. He doesn't have the quad plan, but he's got a triple lutz right there. I was speaking to him earlier this afternoon and talking to him about what it's like to train in Barry with Doug Lee and Elvis, and he said it's amazing. He said the atmosphere is so great, so positive, and he's just learned so much there. And you can see it. I think he's learned that focus that he's been missing in the past.
Called 2 minutes warning, maybe 2 minutes and 40 seconds warning.
Takeshi just got back on the ice last week. This is amazing. What a huge improvement he has made in 1 year.
Takeshi Honda from Japan putting down 8 clean elements. Very happy. I'm so pleased for Takeshi Honda. He has been a star in waiting. Tremendous potential. But just a few hours ago, here was the Takeshi Honda we saw at ringside. Sitting with ice on his ankle. He's been getting acupuncture here as well. Incredibly concerned about whether it would hold up.
I know. Well, I'm sure it's going to be much more difficult task in the long program. There you see him with his new coach, Doug Lee. Take a look at this beautifully light, perfect combination. There's the difference. There's the reason that he will likely finish ahead of Elvis Stoico here.
Incredible speed, too, Bart. Mm-hmm. He has that kind of lightness, easy flow across the ice, all of which translates into huge jumps.
He has the confidence now, and he's taken the second mark, the presentation mark, up so much higher this year. He's been working with choreographer Leanne Miller, and she's done a great job at refining his skating.
He always seemed very shy on the ice to me. Now, mm-hmm. a lot of that is inexperience.
He's come out of his shell, certainly. He's only 18. It's incredible.
5'7", 5'6".
Wow. 5.2 up to 5.7 for required elements.
And this has to be kind of a strange moment for Doug Lee, sitting here in the Kiss and Cry with Takeshi.
Especially now that Takeshi has moved ahead of Elvis Stoico for the short program.
Thank you. The final competitor in this group, representing Canada, Emmanuel Sandu.
Here is our number two in Canada. Another star in the waiting, Emmanuel Sandu.
And another skater who can take advantage here of Elvis's mistake in the short program. But he's had a frustrating week. He's been ill with the flu, and he had a very frustrating warm-up. He can pull it back together here. He's opening with the triple axel combination. Triple, looked like it may have been a 2 foot. That's an element the judges are gonna check on the instant replay. Jump is the triple lutz. He's looking a little more cautious than usual, and he didn't have the check out of that landing. He doesn't have the fire in his eyes that he had at Canadians. Look a little slower than normal.
Part of the biggest thing in having the flu has been his exhaustion, he told me.
Was not there tonight.
That was hard work.
Hard work. Lots of errors.
Hard work for Emmanuel Sandu of Canada. Emmanuel Sandu sitting alongside his longtime coach, Joanne McLeod. Joanne's the head instructor at York Region Skating Academy, and she's moving along with Emmanuel to Vancouver.
Here's the triple axel, definite 2 foot landing there, but he does manage to get the triple toe in. He can do the triple toe off of just about anything. Let's have another look here. Yeah, definite 2 foot there. And he's right in a position for the judges to see that, although they could see it on replay anyway. But you could see right from the start, he was far more cautious than he was at the Canadian Championships. And even in the spins, they were slower than usual. And I think there may have been a deduction here on this change foot spin. The skaters are required to do 6 rotations. 1, 2, I think he just did 5 rotations here. He's a little bit short, and that's going to be a deduction there.
More than anything else, Emmanuel does not want to replay what happened at last year's Worlds, coming off this surprise second place finish at Canadians, and of course all the rigmarole over not being sent to Olympics.
The marks for Emmanuel
but I think having this event
elements.
In between will help him
I
to
agree.
Now
4-7,
get him ready.
4-2, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7, 4-7,
all the deductions on the triple axle, the flip out of the triplets, the combination spin, and even the weakness on the double axle landing.
5-1, 4-7.
Emmanuel Sandu in fifth.
Representing China, Min Zhang.
Okay, we're on a quad watch. Another one of the tremendous Chinese skaters who can do quads till the cows come home. This will be the second element in the program for Min Zhang of China.
And the trick here for him will be the fact that it is second, because he has been having problems with the triple axle. So if he misses the triple axle, like Elvis at the Canadians, it's very difficult to stand up and go into a quad after that. Here he opens with a triple axle. Triple, triple, hangs onto the landing. And the next jump. Is the quad toe a second chance at history here? He does it! He has done it! He has made history. That was clean. I don't know if the crowd knows what they have just witnessed.
We've seen quads landed in the long program. A lot of skaters can do quads, but this is the first year that the ISU has allowed the men to attempt quads in the short. Seen a successful one.
And his heart rate must be
minus.
Just going crazy. The key will be for him now to settle himself down. He still has one more relatively difficult element, and that's a double axle. At the end of that spin, but this is a very memorable performance.
Min Zhang of China, the first skater in history to land the quad in the short program. Min Zhang from China, a skating friend of mine, says he skates and lands his jumps as if he's landing on feathers.
So light and airy. Let's have a look at the combination first. Triple axel was clean. He goes into the triple toe loop. He gets good height, but he's on a lean. He has to lean forward. And that is questionable as to whether that is clean. But look at this quad. There's no question here. Such a weird setup, too. Very different, but very clean. Let's have one more look here.
Straight line on the setup, most unusual for a big rotation jump.
Look how straight he is in the air, tight in the air. Wow, so soft. Unfortunately, though, he let the program get away with him a little bit, away from him a little bit at the end. His final spin looked like it was lacking in revolutions, so he's going to have a couple of minor deductions. But it'll be interesting to see how high the judges start here with the base mark, because we haven't seen a quad landed in the short program yet.
Every one of those judges, however, has been considering the eventuality of the quad appearing.
But not only did he do the quad, he did the most difficult combination as well, the triple axel, triple toe.
5-2, 5-6, 5-4, 5-4.
Some 5-7s up there.
5-7.
Barb, I would say the judges agree with you with regards to the program.
The marks for
final spin, very poor.
5-3. 5-4, 5-1, 5-1, 5-4, 5-5, 5-6. Thank you.
That puts him in second place. Elvis is in third at the moment. Here's Rob.
Australia.
Emmanuel, Barb and Deb said you looked a little cautious. Is that the function of being ill?
Well, I wasn't trying to be cautious, just like physically. I just couldn't get myself to push. It's just been really hard. This is like basically the first full program I've run through the whole week because I've been sick, so it's hard.
When did you get the flu? Did it sort of come on quickly, or could you feel something?
I got it the day I got here, and you know I still have it. So
something like this program, how do you battle back from that for the free skate?
Well, you just have to move on. I don't know what else to say.
Good luck to you.
Thanks.
Our next competitor, representing Canada, Jean-François Hébert.
Here is Warwick, Quebec's Jean-François Hébert, his highest international finish this year, sixth at the Nations Cup.
And it has been a year filled with challenges for Jean-François. He's had several injuries, including a broken wrist this past summer, which he was unable to jump. But he has spent a great deal of time working on other aspects of his skating, which I think has been very positive for him. He opens with a triple axel combination. He's been having some difficulty with this in practice. And he singles. Track here with the triple lutz, puts his hand down.
Barb, you mentioned assets from not being able to jump. One of those, I think the biggest, has been the choreography attention. Both programs, short and long, are fabulous. Musical, interesting.
And the footwork, very, very intricate.
Thank you.
sequence here. One jump left, that's the double axel with rotating turns on the ice into it. Very nice.
Moldavian dance by Jean-Francois Hébert of Canada.
One is Jean-Francois Hébert, but everybody on the Canadian team calls him Ted, as in
Teddy Bear. And he's obviously not very pleased with himself right now. But it is tough when you are struggling with a jump, having difficulties with it, to come out there and do it under the pressure. And obviously he didn't have the confidence that he needed to perform it. He pulled out of the rotation and therefore only doing a single axel instead of the triple. And here's the footwork steps, which they must precede the triple jump with into this triple Lutz right here. You can see he's on the lean right there, reaches down and touches the ice. But I'd say his footwork was probably the best element or elements of the program. Both sets of footwork were great. I love these steps right here. Hard to do.
Hard to do with any speed, easy to do standing still, but any toe work done in a footwork section with any speed at all.
As Shaylin and Victor can attest to from last year.
Hamburger feet. Coached by Eric Gillies, who was ill over Canadians and did not get a chance to see Jean-Francois skate except from the TV in his hospital room. Nice to see him back.
The marks for Jean-Francois Hébert for required elements. 4-0, 3-8, 4-2, 4-4, 3-9, 3-7.
The judges are playing it by the book.
Anybody seeing
for presentation
at this level threes up
four,
on the
nine,
scoreboard? That's
four,
very
five,
disappointing.
5-0, 5-0.
To
five,
give Jean-Francois Hébert seventh in short.
Nine.
More skaters still to come.
Thank you.
Here is the Chinese national champion from Beijing, Sheng Zhang Li.
And of all the very talented Chinese skaters here, he is probably the best all-around skater. He does the quad toe, triple toe combination, although he will not do the quad or hasn't planned to do the quad in the short. Into this combination, triple axel, triple toe. Look at the speed he carries in. Unbelievable. So easy. Nice position on his flying camel spin. He's had the quad for several years, but it's just this year that he has really made such a difference in the rest of his skating, not just concentrating on the jumps, but on the overall package. His next jump is triple loop jump. Circular. And this is what I mean by the improvement he has made. More attention to details. And look at that position, how low he is in that sit spin. Good speed. Thank you.
What tremendous choreographic improvement for Zheng Zheng Li. I don't know, they used to throw flowers onto the ice. Now it's Beanie Babies.
This is going to be very interesting. Let's look at the difference in technical difficulty between Elvis and Zheng Zheng. Zheng Zheng did a more difficult combination. Look at the height and the distance he gets on that triple-triple combination. Beautiful. More difficulty there. However, less difficulty on the triple jump. He did a triple loop. Elvis did the quad toe, but Elvis missed. But the spins were of great quality. The footwork and all around. Just, I'd say, the most improved skater of the year. So clean and sure of himself.
And a year ago, I would not have considered him a musical kind of skater at all. I have been so impressed this week. He hears the music. I think this has been a great vehicle for him, the whole martial arts thing. Obviously, he loved the music too.
And it shows. I'm sure winning the national championships has been a big boost for him.
Just to give you an idea of the depth of talent in China, six senior men do quads, and not just quad toes, all sorts.
And three juniors do quads there.
Astounding.
Jumping machines.
And one is only 12 years old, one of those juniors. What's with the 4'9"?
4'9".
5'2", 5'4".
And Zheng Zheng Li is in fourth place behind Elvis Stoico. The judges are getting the big boo.
Here are the top five placements after the men's short program. Takeshi Honda from Japan is the leader. Min Zhang from China is second. Our Canadian champion Elvis Stoico down in third. Li is fourth from China. Anthony Liu from Australia is fifth. Here's Rob with Elvis Stoico.
Elvis, it appears the rest of the world, at least the four continents that are here, have come in ready to do some business.
I like that. It's been really good. I've been, watching some of the practices, watching the guys are doing great. And, what's nice is being a part of this, because it's nice to see men's skating taking another level.
You started off so very well with the combination. A little trouble, though, on the quad two-footing.
That's fine. I mean, it's a situation where it wasn't going as planned all week. And, I landed it the last 2 days. It was just clicked in. And just to put it in under Chris's situation, and I think it's just more miles. When I got off, it's just miles in the program and getting the trust back in my body.
You've always said that you want to take skating to another level. Here in this competition, the quad, which has almost become a signature piece of yours, is now in the short program, nailed by a Chinese skater.
Yeah, and there's a lot of guys, like I know the Chinese skaters have been doing the last couple of years, and doing them under pressure is the key. And now that we've got it, it's done, now it has to be done. Once it's done in the program once, then you got to put it in. So, all year I've been playing catch up and trying to, I started way behind the rest of the field, and now I feel like I'm almost there, catching up with the rest of the pack and going at my own pace. I can't push myself beyond what I'm capable at this point, and I feel good about what I did, and we'll move on for tomorrow.
How do you feel now compared to how you felt during Canadians?
Oh, geez, probably about 25-30% better at least. Practice-wise, confidence-wise, my body feels good, the leg feels good, and once we get this competition over with, have a good rest, and then set up for the big one in a few weeks.
Good luck in the freeze.
Thank you.
Here's a look at the full men's field. Takeshi Honda of Japan leading, Min Zhang of China in second, Elvis Stoico in third place, Chen Zhang Li of China in fourth, Emmanuel Sandu is in 10th, getting ready for the free skate, and Jean-Francois Hébert is in 11th place as you take a look at the rest of the field. Well, here we are waiting for our marks at the Metro Center in Halifax in the Kissing Crack. Elvis is in third place. Is this a cause for concern, Barb?
For him, he's got to be very pleased with how he skated. It's definitely a step up from his performance at Canadians, but it's got to be disconcerting to have skated well and be sitting in third. He set the bar a few years ago with the quad, and it's very obvious at this event that the rest of the world has caught up, including the Chinese team.
And speaking of the rest of the world, Debbie, we saw something never seen before, a quad in a short program.
Well, you know, I'm not really sure that the audience knew what they had seen. When the quad was landed, there was very light response, beautiful setup, no question of the perfection of the jump. And when we asked the ISU if they wanted to have a look at the tape of the jump, they went, oh, no, thanks. It was good for us.
Well, we're getting ready. We've got the free skates set to go tonight. It should be a great evening here at the Metro Center in Halifax. That is coming up tonight. We'll have highlights of the women's competition.